The iPad went on sale in a number of countries on Friday. More this week. We've got Dan Moren with us to tell us, how did those weekend sales go, Dan?
Well, it sounds like they went pretty good. We don't have hard numbers yet, but speaking at a conference call for an unrelated issue this morning, Apple CEO Tim Cook said that they had a record weekend of iPad sales and that they were really thrilled with the response. So based on that, we can sort of gauge that they did pretty well. They haven't released hard numbers in the past either of sort of their weekend sales, but the first iPad, they sold about 300,000 in the first day, and pre-orders have been sold out of the new iPad for the last week almost. So I would expect the numbers to be pretty solid.
Wow. So now that everyone has this iPad in their hands, have we learned anything new about it?
It's interesting. I mean, there are a couple things floating around the net. A lot of the stuff we sort of knew going in, the better screen. I think the thing that's caught a lot of people by surprise is there is a subtle difference in the weight and size of the new iPad. It's a little bit thicker, a little bit heavier. A lot of that is attributable to the battery, which is a lot higher power in order to compensate for that larger screen and the 4G networking. In addition, I know I've read a lot of people online talking about various color casts to their screen. Some people saying it has a slight yellowish tinge or the color temperature is a little different. Sometimes those things sort of iron out as they go on. I've heard that with pretty much every model of the iPhone or iPad release, but we'll be keeping an eye on it to see if it develops into anything more serious.
So you briefly mentioned that conference call this morning with Tim Cook and their CFO. Some big news for Apple shareholders. What's going on?
A little bit of a surprise, actually. They've been grilled for a while about these huge cash reserves they have, which are now up to about $98 billion, which is a lot of money. And so, of course, a lot of analysts have wanted to know, what do they plan on doing with that? You know, is it something they're going to sit on and keep for acquisitions? And they've been pressured several times to do dividends or stock buybacks. So they announced this morning, in fact, they would do both dividends to their existing shareholders, as well as repurchasing some stock to the tune of about $10 billion. So that's their way of returning some value to shareholders, while at the same time maintaining enough money to both run the company and have a pretty sizable war chest if any opportunities come along.
So what's that mean for people who own Apple stock? And also, what's next in this whole thing for Apple and shareholders?
Well, if you already own Apple stock, you're going to see a dividend of about $2.65 per share, which they say, you know, over the first year, the annual payout will be about $10 billion as well. As far as what goes on down the line, they said they'll continually look into, you know, how that's going and whether or not they should adjust the cost. But I think their bottom line is always, we really want to do what's right for Apple and the shareholders, and we'll continue really to innovate with our products, which is our biggest priority overall. So it's not as though business is really changing for them. They're just sort of adding this as another tool in their arsenal.
So we've got more countries getting iPads this week. Further along than that, what's coming up down the line for Apple? Do we have any predictions or rumors that we're hearing?
Well, the biggest thing that we sort of already know about is their new version of macOS, which will come out later this summer, called Mountain Lion. They showed off a preview release of that, and they just issued a second developer preview release this week. So that's coming along, and we'll probably see release sometime this summer. I think given their past performance, we can probably predict that there will be a new model of iPhone at some point this year, and that we'll see some refreshes to the Mac lines as well. But sort of the big question mark is still this Apple TV a lot of people have rumored about. Of course, they have their little set-top box, which they continually describe as a hobby, but there have been a lot of rumors about them launching a full-fledged TV set. So that's the kind of thing we're keeping an eye on just to see what's going to happen, but nothing solid in that department yet.
All right, Dan Moren with Macworld, thanks for coming on.
Thanks, Nick.